You know, the Bible says, he who comes to God must believe that God is. He is. Not he was. He is. So when we come before God, who has no image, who has no form, who is invisible, who is full of light, how are you going to imagine how God looks like? The picture of God that we have is the perfect personification of the Lord Jesus Christ. But beyond that, when the Bible says God dwells in unapproachable light, he's a father of lights. What does it mean? Father of lights. Unapproachable. If no one can approach before that light, how can anyone see that light? These are just the kindergarten of God theology. And that is mind-boggling for us. What about all the other things? So let's throw away our old box theology. And let's come before God with an open heart. And let's just say, Spirit of the Living God, there are so many things I don't understand. But I claim to know that I understand. That's our problem, you know. Isn't it? That's our great problem. You know, the Bible says, he who comes to God must believe that God is. He is. Not he was. He is. So when we come before God, who has no image, who has no form, who is invisible, who is full of light, how are you going to imagine how God looks like? The picture of God that we have is the perfect personification of the Lord Jesus Christ. But beyond that, when the Bible says God dwells in unapproachable light, he's a father of lights. What does it mean? Father of lights. Unapproachable. If no one can approach before that light, how can anyone see that light? These are just the kindergarten of God theology. And that is mind-boggling for us. What about all the other things? So let's throw away our old box theology. And let's come before God with an open heart. And let's just say, Spirit of the Living God, there are so many things I don't understand. But I claim to know that I understand. That's our problem, you know. Isn't it? That's our great problem.